upon the examination of the galaxies of space, images begin to appear. Images of strange and powerful forces.
Rush! Everyone has a price for the $1 million man.
But of all the forces in the universe, six of the most powerful prepare to explode. Your boy Rick Flair.
You have to be the man.
Prepare to captain their respective teams. Champion versus champion. It's the ultimate challenge. It's Clash of the Titans.
Super Bowl. I've been to the World Series. I've even been to the Rolling Stones. But there is one event that surpasses them all. I'm fired up.
Whoa, it's going to be something else. The festivities are about to get underway, so let's go down to ringside. And now, here to sing America the Beautiful, the Queen of Soul, Miss Aretha Franklin!
Supercard to end all supercards. 26 matches to determine the number one in all of professional wrestling. High flying action as the model Rick Martel goes one-on-one with flying Brian Pillman. Rowdy Roddy Piper and Paul Orndorff to square off against the fabulous Freebirds. The greatest Intercontinental champion of all time, the Honky Tonk Man, takes on Nikita Koloff. The British Bulldogs of Davey Boy Smith and the Dynamite Kid to compete against Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. Monty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels of the Rockers look to tear it up against the Rock and Roll Express. Jake the Snake Roberts to battle head-on with Terry Funk in a no-holds-barred, no-disqualification match. Ravishing Rick Rude to take on United States champion, the total package, Lance Luger. In what should be a technical showcase for the ages, Mr. Perfect to lock horns with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase collides with Magna TA within the confines of a steel cage. Axe and smash of demolition to finally square up against Hawk and Animal, the Road Warrior. Hitman Bret Hart, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the Hart Foundation, to square up against the Steiner Brothers. Randy Savage, the Ultimate Warrior, and Hogan clash against Dusty Rhodes, Sting, and Ric Flair. It's Clash of the Titans.
The tag team attraction, scheduled for one fall, at a total combined weight of 465 pounds, Shawn Michaels, Marty Jannetty, the Rocker!
Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson, The Rock, and Who is
are trying to do here.
Well, these guys are such high flyers, such high risk moves, take all kinds of chances.
Ricky Morton, whose father was a wrestling referee down in the Tennessee area for many, many years, so he is a second generation athlete.
Oh, look at this! Referee certainly will have his hands full controlling this one before it's over. Nice bridge up out of there! What presence of mind by Shawn Michaels to pull that one out!
What an exchange there offensively, Gorilla. Great teamwork there. And the Rock and Roll Express, after that early setback, looking very, very impressed here.
Look out! Beautiful! Caught him in the head scissors! It is deafening in here! Rock and Roll Express certainly showing their superiority right now.
And then the double take. Just a little added extra, just a little something extra. Rock and Roll Express, one move ahead, one step ahead. Side headlock as he walks up top. You know, Robert Gibson's mother is a deaf mute. And you'll see the Rock and Roll Express oftentimes signing each other.
But he's firing back, Jess. Setting him up once again. No, nice reversal. Oh! Unloading right after right. Look out! And a double headlock. Whacked him right across the small of the back. The edge you gotta give to the Rockers because they seem to know what each other is thinking. In for the ride. Big back to beauty. How painful that is. We can't feel it. We can only see it on the face. These two youngsters got a lot of fight left in them. And they're getting some support from this capacity crowd. Suplex coming up. Oh, well executed.
Textbook. Both men down. Now it's a matter of who can make the tag.
This place is gone wild. Tag made. Oh, beautiful move. Right. What guts, what fight.
Morton is fighting on instinct here. And they are getting it all right here. Morton fighting back.
Oh, look at that.
things not looking too well right now at this particular point in time for the Rockers.
And sleeper. And this is, like I said, the kind of double teaming that the Rockers cannot afford to take.
Came right out the back door. The pendulum has sort of swung here in this one.
Beautiful kick.
Right into Kisser. Set him up perfectly.
Morton is not the largest athlete in this building, but he is gritty. He's tenacious. But he's got that smaller frame, and he really took a pounding there.
Ricky Morton needs desperately to make the tag here.
This young man from the state of Tennessee is just about out of it. Morton, small in stature, large in design.
Big heart. Definitely needs to make the tag. He's got to get out of there.
Ricky Morton with the ride.
Got them both down. Double knocker. He has the opportunity, but can he get there?
And he does. Gibson with hard right hands. Finding their mark. Gibson should be well rested. He hits it. It's over. And he does. This should be it.
And they're keeping the Rockers in their corner where they're able to tag in.
Oh, look at that. Beautiful neck breaker by Shawn Michaels.
He makes a tag.
Smooth slam. Jannetty exploded. He's all over the place. Oh, smooth. Look out. Oh, power slam and a beauty.
It could be over.
Save the day for his team.
It's not ethical, but it's great tag team strategy. And look at this teamwork. Continuity. Here it comes.
A beautiful move. Oh, they almost got double crossed again. They did. Oh, a miscommunication there. It'll be mayhem before it's all over. You can bet on it. In the meantime, the action continues inside the ring. Christian kick. It's wild here. Setting up here as he called something to his partner.
Oh, there it is. It's got to be over now. Gibson's got it covered. The referee finally was distracted there. Finally got back too late.
It's back. It's mayhem here.
And a moonsault. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my. A reverse moonsault. What a high-risk maneuver.
All kinds of action right now inside the ring and outside as well. Drop kick and a beauty. High-risk area here, but not for this guy. Oh, God. Here it goes.
The winners of this bout, the Rockers!
That was a little bit too much double teaming in there for my book.
Well, the referee let it go at his discretion as all four men were in the ring for quite some time. Boy, are they happy. Talk about excitement.
Wow.
Right now, we're going to go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
With me at this time, the Slickster, Akeem the African Dream, and a big boss man. Gentlemen, is this the match you wanted all along?
Chill out, Holmes. Chill out then while the Slickster lays it all out for you. You see, this is the Slickster's third law of wrestling dynamics. See, we are three men, and they are two men, and it'll go presto, we will win.
Now that remains to be seen, Slickster.
No, brother, kill or be killed, eat or be eaten, and I am hungry.
You have the right to suffer. You have the right to feel pain. If you wish to have an attorney present, I'll hurt him too.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
Hey, school is out, Holmes, you dunce cap. Hey, now it's time for us three men's to go out and beat those two men's, cause it's the law.
I can't believe it. Managers to be a factor to what degree, I don't know. Let's go back to you.
Currently in the ring from the PG Highlands, weighing 245 pounds, Superfly Jimmy.
Gary Hart presents, from the land of the rising sun, the pearl of the Orient, the great Muta.
Superfly. What a tremendous success he's been here in the World Wrestling Federation. Taking on all comers. This will be his toughest competition to date, I do believe. Holy mackerel, this thing's going back and forth. Nice reversal. Superfly underneath that one. Whoa! Right into Kisser. Oh, look at this. Holy mackerel. He was 10 foot high. Tell right off the bat, referee's gonna have trouble in this one. What a battle! Look at this! Oh! Oh! Right between the eyes! Second turnbuckle on the inside.
Oh, oh, with it. The headbutt!
Oh, he tried to plant it.
And Snuka's going up!
What's this? What is that? Oh, look at this! That's inexcusable! Not looking too good right now as he's getting pummeled here. Battered pretty badly.
Moon over the top! High cross body. And he defies gravity. And now will Muda be able to capitalize?
Oh, big mistake. Slingshot. Oh, nice ball.
Maybe the biggest mistake of the match has just been made.
Wow, elbows finding their mark right in the sternum area. Oh, look at that. Right on the mark. Look out! Never seen Superfly! Oh, God, I don't like this! Look out! Oh! Forget about it! It's history!
Here's your winner, the Great Muta!
Gentlemen, and with me now, the self-proclaimed million-dollar champion, Ted DiBiase. Just what do you have up your sleeve tonight?
Wealth is what it's all about, Okerlund. It's the bottom line, and my wealth runs deeper than just dollars because I'm rich in ring prowess, flush with technical skill, and extremely well-off when it comes to wrestling ability.
Well, you may indeed be a great wrestler, Ted DiBiase, but I can't help but think tonight you're up to something.
Money isn't everything. It's the only thing. And everyone has a price for the million-dollar man.
Right now, let's go back to the arena.
This tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Currently in the ring, introducing first the manager, the Doctor of Style, Slick. And he represents an total combined weight of 814 pounds. Boss Man and the team, the Twin Towers!
Biggest tag team in professional wrestling today, bar none.
Los Angeles, California. Total combined weight, 422 pounds. Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton, the Fantastics.
Very diverse styles, very much contrasting styles here. So I think that the Fantastics have got to really utilize their quickness and set that pace early in the match.
Butterfly shoulder block!
He should not even be counting that. That was the most flagrant double teaming I've seen in a long while.
I thought it was rather exciting and rather innovative.
Power display here by the Big Boss Man.
Oh, that's an insult right there.
It's like a whoa! He got his attention all right with a drop kick.
Certainly did. He nails Akeem, who was daydreaming.
Daydreaming?
Yes, he was, sitting over there on the apron.
Well, I would imagine Akeem figured maybe a little more sportsmanship. You know, that's a cheap shot, Gorilla.
Nice arm bringer.
There's what we'd like to see out of these two, that continuity, that tag team.
So far, the Twin Towers have not been successful.
Nice Fulton. And Fulton is coming out with a lot of fist and fire here.
You know, maybe they figured since they have this huge weight advantage that they were going to waltz through this match. They're grabbing a body part and they're trying to take it away from Akeem.
Look out!
Whoa! Oh, look at that.
Rolls right into the Big Boss Man, who had already legally made the tag.
And here's a mean man in the ring right now. I mean, this dude is just plain mean.
He'll teach you some law and order.
He likes to interrogate.
And wide open here. Look out. We'll be lucky if the ring stays together.
This is exactly what I predicted would happen. They could run, but they couldn't hide forever.
Twin Towers have definitely cut the ring in half here.
We know that they have great resiliency, that they can take a tremendous amount of punishment.
It'll make you wish you were somewhere else.
And there's that weight advantage that I spoke of, Gorilla, right there.
Whoa, there's a mistake, and a big one.
Great drop kicks. And Fulton makes a very timely tag. And now Tommy Rogers may do some flying on his own.
A big offensive move, perhaps out of desperation.
Now the tempo's picked up.
Well, that's what they have to do.
Could be all over.
No.
Duck underneath. Oh, wow, what a shot. That's 400 pounds plus up there.
Team. Look at this. This is an atrocity. These guys couldn't compete one on
one.
What a move by the Boss Man.
Africa.
I believe he irritated Akeem.
Let's go back and take a look at some of the action that went down earlier on. Look at this, just as he's turned around, wow.
Wham, and did he catch
it? Me.
That's lights out time, Gorilla.
What a way to get your attention.
Sometimes they do it and sometimes they won't. So I said to this girl, hey, you get out. And she got to her feet and began to shout. You're a dinosaur, bro, a dinosaur, bro. And you're always lying to your friends. You're a dinosaur, bro.
Thoughts as you approach this devastating matchup.
I'm like the card dealer with the marked cards. I'm the man with the loaded dice, and everything goes the way that I want it to go. Too many wrestlers are going home with blemished records now, because every time I step in the ring, I take what I want, and it's always my opponent.
He is one frightening individual back to ringside.
Introducing first to my left, King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd.
The opponent
picks him up in a bear hug. Look out! Rams it! Look out, Avalanche! Bundy with that big avalanche just crushed him. Oh, my God! Unbelievable history, undoubtedly, in my opinion, made here.
The winners of this bout, King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd.
He's a mountain with legs and feet and arms. And holy mackerel, that one's going to stay in the record books for a long, long time. Right now, let's go back to our locker room area.
So far, we have witnessed some tremendous action. I'm sure it is about to continue as we get set for the model Rick Martel.
As you can see, the model is a man for all seasons, always dressed for success, always looking the best at every occasion. I'm out to show everybody that not only I am the best at modeling, but I am the best wrestler of the World Wrestling Federation. Yes, always dressed for success, and successful I will be.
Let's get back out to ringside.
From Asbury Park, New Jersey, weighing 333 pounds, Bam Bam Bigelow!
Right down the road, not too far from here, Asbury Park, New Jersey, the home of this big guy.
You know what I call these two? The ugly twins.
Well, I certainly hope that they did some reinforcing on the ring.
Yeah.
street fight environment now. That's what Bigelow wants.
Oh, nice clothesline.
The most recruited high school athlete in America coming out of high school. He's being tested right here. Oh, what a... But look, Bigelow's right back up.
What a match this is, Gorilla.
Oh, look at this power display by Batman.
Here we go.
Big splash.
Batman's got the definite advantage here. He's a man with a lot of determination. Whoa.
He got out of the way. Close line. Oh, he did a 360. Oh, what a shot.
He wanted to get Bigelow, above all, off his feet to negate some of his strength. How much punishment and it has inflicted on Bam Bam Bigelow, we don't know right now.
Oh, he got him with a headbutt.
Whoa. Whoa.
The power moves. It's high impact. That's got to be his recipe for success here.
2.5 count. Look at him alone.
And now the big animal from the University of Oklahoma is opening it up.
Oh, drop kick! I don't believe it! It took everything out of Bam Bam. Anything and everything is possible. But Bam Bam looks to be in a whole lot of trouble. Bam Bam reaching back for that little extra something.
But I don't think even the crowd can play a part. I think there's too much out of Bam Bam at this point, Gorilla.
It's going now on adrenaline. This crowd has gotten back into it.
Look at this. Bam Bam with a big ball. Listen to this crowd. Slingshot. Yes. Over for the cover. No.
And now Bam Bam Bigelow has got to reach down. Perhaps farther than he has ever reached. And fight back.
He's on fire. Almost three. Whoa, was that close?
But now can he put a pinning predicament on the biggest challenger that he has ever faced?
Oh, look at that.
Bigelow just went out right on his knee. Bigelow has had, he's had knee surgery. Of strength. You can hear that one. That could be judged on the Richter scale.
Look at this. Oh, the whole ring just shifted. The ring just shifted about 8 inches.
First of all, I would like to offer you a friendly warning, an admonishment, if you will, as we approach this incredible encounter. Who knows what may be the end result of this matchup, and I must warn the faint of heart to use viewer discretion before you take a look at the action.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to kill you, that's right. No, I'm going to tell you what. I might just torture him, and then I'm going to kill him. No, I'll tell you what. I'm going to castrate him first, then I'm going to kill him, and then I'm going to torture him. No, whoa, wait a minute. What am I going to do? Oh, I am looking so forward to this.
Let's go back to ringside.
At a total combined weight of 611 pounds, here are the Powers.
The Team of Doom!
Thank you.
you see the strength of the Barbarian right there. Ooh,
boy, he's thick, huh?
That's not fun to look at.
Two really tough dudes.
Doom number one in there. And the backgrounds of Doom as mysterious as their identity. Side headlock.
Barbarian, what a powerhouse he is. Oh! Nice reverse knife edge. Ran him over just like a tank. Oh, nice reversal there by the Barbarian. Whoa, he caught one. And another shot to the kisser. I was waiting for this grudge to come to a head here, and it certainly has. Whole lot at stake. Look at the power. Every match so important.
I'll tell you, Gorilla, you can hear them shots all the way back where we're at.
Double axe handle.
It's not often you see the Warlord down.
Backbreaker. No suplex.
There you see the difference in the power.
Oh, look at this, belt over the top.
There's no doubt that she is the boss of this outfit, as they say out in Oklahoma. The question here is, how much more can he take?
Unloading with some heavy artillery of his own. Smart move. Take the big man off his feet. They know how to roughhouse. Look at this, stepping right on the throat. There's the count. Now they've cut the ring in half once again to their advantage. Oh, he's going for a pile driver, Jess.
Wow.
But will their power be enough against these two big guys?
Rammed into the top turnbuckle. I'm surprised at the output on the part of the Warlord and the Barbarian here, Jess. Went for a suplex, couldn't get that. Big body up there.
Wow, what a show of strength, Gorilla.
What power it takes to do that. And he makes the tag. Oh, wow, what a move.
If he hits this, it's trouble.
Oh, what a clothesline. Boy, this is a war. He got nailed and nailed good. It's turned into a Pier 6 brawl. Look out. Whoa. Oh, look at this power display. Two count now.
We got all four of them.
Whip now. Oh, beautiful power slam. The power came to play there. Whoa, was that close. Both men jockeying here.
Uh-oh. This ought to be good.
Mayhem breaking loose here.
Uh-oh. Oh, look at this.
I don't think he's going to survive this. Power slam. Random with a headbutt. Hooks it like he won't get up from that. Let's get the official one.
Here are your winners, the Powers of Pain.
Listen to this ovation. And rightly so.
All right, Bobby the Brain Heat and Ravishing Rick Rude. Now, as a journalist, I must ask, why do you insist upon wearing those tights?
Let's clear the air here. Everybody in professional wrestling knows this man has the greatest physique going. All you women know this man has the greatest physique going. All you poor humanoids know it.
That's right. The men of America are accusing me for ruining their relationships. I can't help it. Your old ladies love me. It isn't my fault. I'm the sexiest man alive, and that isn't my fault. Bobby Heenan and Ravishing Rick Rude shattered a lot of dreams.
And this is just the beginning. You can bank on that.
Let's get back to ringside for more action.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a tag team contest. It is scheduled for one fall. Managed by Luscious Johnny V, ladies and gentlemen, the Dream Team, at a total combined weight of 521 pounds, from San Francisco, California, Brutus Beefcake, and from Seattle, Washington, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, from the dark side, Ravishing Randy and Loverboy Dennis, along with Paul E. Dangerously, the original Midnight Express.
This is going to be a classic confrontation here.
Hammer going to work now.
The longer the match, the better he likes it.
Look at those short forearm smashes by the Hammer. It's a 15-minute time limit. Sometimes he doesn't get warmed up by that. Look at those chops. Rudai looks to be in excellent condition, as always. In fact, he's bigger than I've ever seen him, Jeff.
The hammer's like a machine. If it goes long distance, it's going to go in Hammer's favor.
Coming off the ropes, look out! Oh, look at that! Did you see that? What a desperate move that was!
Sends him back inside the ring where you need him to put him away if you can. Whoa, excuse me. Surprised him with an elbow right to the kisser. Suplex coming up. Who's going to get it? Beautiful maneuver.
Nice move there by Randy Rose. Tags in Dennis Condrey. Nice team move. Dennis Condrey showing that awesome vicious streak that he possesses. And Randy Rose follows up with more punishment.
Come on, ref.
That's going to slow down most normal men, I'll tell you that. And Dennis Condrey is the man you want in to really execute the punishment.
No! Whoa! This will separate the men from the boys right here. Oh, look at this. Shoulder breaker, perhaps? Yes.
Hammer's a rough and tough wrestler. That's his style.
Oh, right on the back of the head, right in the external occipital protuberance area. Oh, look at this. Elbow after elbow.
But as the match wears on, it's like this guy gets stronger and stronger. Now go for the figure four. Now's when he should go for it, Gorilla.
Rudai, intense now. He's got that powerful upper body.
Wham!
I believe it's the beginning of the end here, perhaps. What a battle.
Oh, he's going for the figure four.
Oh, look at that.
They're not just going to try to win this. They're going to try to
hurt
him.
He's going to try to break his leg.
Oh, this one is like a powder keg. Dangerous and very livid.
Come on, ref, either get that away from him or disqualify him.
Wow.
Oh, 360 job. Uh-oh, look out. Oh, what a clothesline. The hammer's down. Pulling out all the stops. He's got him set up right here. Whoa, he nailed it.
Whoa, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
He got him. Might have been a handful of tights.
The winners of this contest, the Dream Team.
Well, I'll tell you, Gorilla, it's not nearly over yet. It's been unbelievable.
What a confrontation. Right now, let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund and an interview that took place earlier on.
All right, standing next to me, one of the most versatile wrestlers in World Wrestling Federation history, Tito Santana.
I've got a lot of friends in the WWF, but once I hit the ring, friendship is over. I'm coming to fight to win. Tito Santana coming out a winner. Arriba!
All right, let's get back out to ringside.
Wrestling fans, this match is for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. He is accompanied by the executive director of the Four Horsemen, James J. Dillon. Introducing from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 269 pounds, Barry Windham.
From Tocula, Mexico, weighing 244 pounds, Tito Santana.
Santana not going to be able to swap strength here. Working on the arm. Got a nice bar. Santana does.
Nice move. Windham using leverage. The key word we'll be talking about in this match.
Wow. Vicious maneuver, Gorilla Monsoon.
That'll take all the starch out of you and in a hurry.
There's nowhere to go but down. And he follows it up. Standing rocket. All the way out to the ring. This is not what J.J. Dillon wanted the early part of this match to be like.
Inverted atomic drop.
Windham fighting, nowhere to go. He's got, look at how he has Wyndham's neck crimped.
Both of these guys will be pulling out all the stops. You can bet on that one. Oh, beautiful maneuver. Wow, what a devastating move. Drop kick and over the top.
Wyndham's the one that we have the concern for right now. The big youngster from Sweetwater, Texas.
I expected they would come out here and in the first couple of minutes, let it all hang out and see what happens.
Chico firing out of that corner.
He went down and went down hard.
But oh my God, he missed it. And Barry Wyndham will not make many fatal errors. And he will capitalize as he is doing right now. The Lariat. He nailed him with a Lariat. Oh yeah, right hand. And another one. Great big rights. And Wyndham is rising to a level that I have never seen him compete on.
Wow, couldn't believe Chico Santana could kick out of that. Landing hard on the back of his head.
Tito Santana in a whole heap of trouble here.
He's 6 feet six. The young lion of the Horseman organization. Barry Wyndham.
He needs a little bit of support from the fans right now. He's going to pull out of it.
Yes, he
small
did.
Package. Could be all over now.
Wyndham is showing us what he is made of. We talked about the second generation status. The claw, and Wyndham is so emotionally involved, so emotionally. Look at him, he's beside himself. I've never seen Wyndham look any better than we have seen in this one. He finally breaks the claw, always thinking. A wrestler's wrestler is Barry Wyndham. He's up top! He missed it!
Santana got a lot of things in his arsenal, though. Beautiful maneuver by Santana. Close line city. Whoa, almost got the three down. Oh, planted him face first. That'll get your attention.
Chico learned that move in the Mexican Football League, the MFL.
Please.
This could be submission time.
Figure four by Tito.
He's got it. Chico Santana's won many a match with that move.
And J.J. Dillon wants a disqualification.
Oh, look out. Are you kidding?
Wow. We're getting a lot more than we bargained for here, Gorilla.
We certainly are. Oh, that patented flying forearm of Tito Santana. He might have knocked him out. Oh, turned around and ran right into a clothesline. Oh, look at this. This is where he's most effective. Look out.
Whoa.
Oh.
Barry Wyndham!
Unbelievable. Right now, folks, we're going to go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
Capital gentlemen with me right now with the opportunity of a lifetime tonight.
Oh, lots of things change in life. People change, places change, things change. The Berlin Wall came tumbling down. Preachers and politicians fall off their pedestal. New ones rise up to take their place. And a lot of things change in professional wrestling, especially over the last couple of years. But some things never change. Today, we're going to do everything we can to beat them, to hurt them, and to put them out of wrestling. Some things never change. We're still the greatest tag team combination in the history of professional wrestling. Always have been and always will be, regardless of who says different.
Let's get back out to ringside.
From the dark side, total combined weight, 470 pounds. Beautiful Bobby, Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
the early advantage, and Sweet Stan and Beautiful Bobby showing their dominance early.
Double team effort. Oh, look at this, the battering ram. Yeah.
I guess they call that using your hand.
Absolutely. All right, come on, ref. Oh, 360 job. Referee's rapidly losing control of this one.
That happens every time the Bushwhackers wrestle, if you can call it wrestling.
Jim Cornette, I think he's worried about this. This is going to really bother him, I'm telling you that right now.
I'll tell you what, these guys are a little bit more clever than they may want you to believe.
Whoa, he's biting him! Now what cause is there for him to bite him, Hansu?
Big back drop! Perhaps hungry. I call him wrestling.
I call it more like street fighting.
Can you be bribed? I'm asking you. $5,000.
What a bulldog headlock. What a move using Stan Lane's physical position for their own advantage. What a backbreaker. Man, that is teamwork. How much longer can he last? Oh, the 360 backbreaker. Eaton's air attack and Lane's ground. Complement each other very well. It's easy to see why they're the United States Tag Team Champions. He's not breaking anybody's heart in this building. I can promise you that right now. It may be academic right here. One has to think that their game plan has been very well established. I want to tell you something.
You're not going to beat these Bushwhackers with an abdominal stretch, I don't believe, Jess, because the word submit is not in their vocabulary.
Gorilla, you can beat anybody with a submission hold if you get it on right. I don't care who you are.
And still, not enough to put the guy down.
Well, I'll say this, you know, the Bushwhackers are tough. I mean, to eat the food that they consume, you better be tough.
Just like a ping pong ball, back and forth. He almost got it.
Whoa.
He almost decapitated him. Luke and Butch can do it with the best of them.
Ah! Double stomach breaker, I guess you
could. He's hooking the leg here. Could be all over. Come on. I suppose you condone this too, Jess.
Well, not exactly, Gorilla.
Whoa. As he nails him. Believe it.
I think this one's over now.
The winners of the match, Beautiful Bobby, Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
Handsome Harley Race and the Junkyard Dog. A lot of events leading up to this one. We're going to take a look at them right now.
Why this match? At this point in your career.
You know what I mean, Gene? This country never had no queen. This country ain't never had no king. And only time that my mom and dad ever told me to bow down to anybody, it would the good Lord above come on this earth and tell J.Y.D. where you going, up the ladder or down the ladder. I don't understand, baby. Handsome Holler Race, who do you think you dealing with?
Let's get back to ringside for more action.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 249 pounds, Harley Race.
From Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 281 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Okay.
up and we're off.
The bell is gone, we're underway. Oh, look, smacked him right in the kisser.
I believe the feeling out process is over here.
Whip it, no, up on top and over. Oh, got caught in a scoop slam. The dog on all fours, his favorite position. A 360. Listen to this crowd.
Harley Race, what can you say about this man? He has done it all in the sport of wrestling.
Oh, telegraph that move a little bit. Look out.
Wow. Wow.
He nailed him with it.
Woo.
Oh, look at those shots. Those right hands.
Wow.
He nailed him with it. Junkyard Dog treating him just like a pail of garbage. Starting to unload with a heavy artillery. Nailed him with all that momentum going forward.
And Harley Race saw the opening.
Took advantage of it. Softened him up even a little bit more.
Perfectly executed neck breaker by the master of it.
Look at this.
What a beautiful move. He sees measuring his moves, Gorilla. You don't want to waste energy out there either.
Suplex perhaps coming up. Nicely executed. Two count. Going for the cover but didn't get it.
Those are teeth rattlers, Matsu.
They certainly are. Uh-oh. He's got him up there. And wow, did he nail him.
I'd go for a cover right here.
One thing about Harley Race, there'll be no wasted motion with him. He's literally been wrestling all his life. Had his first match at age 15.
Oh, a headbutt, and the dog got out of the way.
Here's a move I like out of... Race is crazy to try to do that to the JYD. That's the toughest part about the JYD. He's got that 4-inch cranium up there.
Oh, the big headbutt. And he's looking for a way to bail out.
Both men could be counted out here.
Scoop the leg out. I'm sure both of these guys are conscious of the count going on inside the ring. He better not.
Oh! This is terrible. This is horrible.
Dangerous, high-risk move, and it didn't work. Coming in, perhaps a suplex. No, scoop slam. Nailed him with it and drove him down into the canvas. Upside down and over.
Well, I'll tell you, he's definitely got the fans behind him. That's obvious, Gorilla.
Oh, he grabbed him. There's the brain up on the apron. What's he doing now? Give me a break, Jess. What is that? Talk about outside interference. Look out. Go. Belly to belly suplex. He nailed him with it.
Beautifully executed.
Oh, got him. Count. He got him.
He got him.
Here's your winner.
Distraction there just from the outside with the brain.
The brain didn't touch anybody. Well, what is this? Wait a minute.
Bobby the Brain either looking for somewhere to hide.
And that was a beautiful belly-to-belly suplex.
Jumped up on the apron.
Jesse, it's just unreal what's going down.
I've seen plenty of lousy NBA championships in my day, but we definitely are not seeing, we're seeing the greatest spectacle in wrestling history
this
right now.
This is the slam match. From Grenoble, in the French Alps, weighing 476 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
Look at the big grin on his kisser, Jesse. He looks very confident.
And his opponent, from the Sudan, weighing 360 pounds, the madman from the Sudan, Abdullah the Butcher!
Whoa, and look at that, there's no turnbuckle pad!
What happened to it?
What the heck happened to the turnbuckle pad?
He's pulling out all the stops early!
I think this match is over with right now, Gorilla.
What can we say about Abdullah the Butcher that has not already been said? Using that mass and all that bulk!
Oh, look at that!
Reached right around and grabbed him by the throat. Right in front of the referee. Yeah, but he's got the count of five to break it. He could choke to four.
The 460-pound wild man from the Sudan.
Right in a kisser with a headbutt.
Whoa.
Look out. Oh, look, and he nailed the referee. Oh, he cracked up right on across the back. Now both men fighting for
the chair.
Oh.
Can you imagine what that felt like, Gorilla?
Chop by Andre. Hit
two ham hocks. And that'll dislocate your shoulder quick.
It's no longer a joke. He's into the trapezius muscle.
That's
Jeff.
Right. That's totally legal.
Don't want to get disqualified here.
Andre just laying all that 550 pounds. Look at it. Driving it in, Gorilla.
Andre looks awesome. Oh, there's another choke. The big guy's really stunned. The big guy didn't hurt him. Look at this. Andre picks him up. He's dropped in. +25,000 on their feet as Andre slams. Look at this. This place has come apart.
The winner of the slam match, Andre the Giant.
All right, with me at this time, Kurt Hennig, Mr. Perfect. I understand they call you that for a good reason.
Everybody knows what kind of athlete I am, and what you people are looking at is not only the greatest athlete in the world, not only the greatest wrestler of modern time, but the greatest wrestler of all time. And there's nobody in the World Wrestling Federation that can put a flaw on my record. So remember this, nobody beats Mr. Perfect. Nobody.
Let's get back out to ringside.
From Singapore, weighing 243 pounds, Games Master Kevin Sullivan. And ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner, hailing from Syracuse, New York, he weighs 237 pounds, Captain Mike Rotunda.
At a total combined weight of 476 pounds, here are Jock and Women, the Fabulous Rujo Brothers.
This is going to be interesting. If the Rougeaus and Jimmy Hart can keep it wrestling, without a doubt, they're the superior tag team.
Rotunda has had a very self-confident look on his face. Played football and wrestled at Syracuse. Has held this television championship for almost 1 year. Rotunda cannot taunt him. He's got to go for the pin right here.
Better be checking the teeth out after that one. Setting him up once again. Irish whip in. Look out. Nice move there, look.
Beautiful nip-up by Jacques Rougeau.
It's a little early for celebrating, I think, Jess.
Positively.
Tags in the very evil and demented Kevin Sullivan. He's got some very, obviously, some very unique communication skills. He certainly has been able to reach Mike Rotunda in ways that no one else has. Kevin Sullivan taking a cheap shot. Why anybody would want to follow the demented ramblings of a maniacal individual like Kevin Sullivan is beyond me.
Oh, look at that! Boy, he was about a half a second too late there.
Now the Rougeaus need to dictate this match.
Well, Raymond could do that. He wanted to grab his attention, he did.
And fans, I would like to remind you, all you fans watching this event live here on Pay-Per-View, we certainly appreciate you bringing us into your home or wherever you may be.
And look at this. Look at that show of athletic prowess right there. That was classic, good tag team wrestling. And look at this.
Quick thinking, or it would have been curtains right there.
Great move there by Mike Rotunda. Right back on the attack. Now Rotunda with a big elbow, and he does it again. It's so hard to remain unemotional when you see your partner being brutalized and you're taunted. Oh! He came right into the foot of Kevin Sullivan. Jumped both feet in the abdomen.
Reverse chin lock now, sitting right on the small of the back in the kidney area.
This match could well end up whichever team has the most endurance to keep up this kind of pace in the ring.
And he makes the tag. Inverted atomic drop. Backdrop down the...
Wow. this, it's all over. Bombs away. He nailed him with it. Beautifully executed. Could be all over here. He got it.
The winners of this bout, the Fabulous Russo Brothers.
Action already, very, very hot and heavy, and still more to come in the form of a big tag team bout. Unquestionably, one of the most promising tag teams I have ever seen. I want to welcome Rick and Scott, the Steiner Brothers. Gentlemen, I got to tell you, you got your work cut out for you.
In the WWF, you have some of the greatest athletes in the world, and the competition is high. Well, me and my brother thrive on competition. Things are going to get very interesting.
Rick, you're ready for this one.
You know, Gene, these guys are unpredictable, but me and my brother are going to go out with a game plan. We're going to do what we do best, and that's wrestle.
Thank you very much, the Steiner Brothers. With that, let's get back to ringside.
From Cocoa Beach, Florida, weighing 234 pounds, Rick the Model.
He weighs 225 pounds. Flying Brian Pillman.
Well, this is going to be a classic matchup. You're going to see some tremendous moves in this bout. Speed, agility, knowledge, it's all in there. All the ingredients necessary for a great match.
And this will be a very offensive-minded matchup. I talked to Pillman last Sunday. He said he was going to try to change his strategy somewhat and perhaps Matt wrestle two athletes that like to generate so much offense through the air. And a drop kick. Great quickness, and they both went for a drop kick. What a competitive situation. Pillman was so stoic. This youngster has overcome so many obstacles. Pillman trying to counter. They're jockeying for position here.
Making a mistake here. Martel didn't do his homework. Close line and a 360.
And both feet right to the face. Pillman now. Oh, Pillman caught him. And caught him with a close line. Head scissors by Flying Bryant. Irish whip to the other side. But this time turned it into a sunset flip. Very uniquely done. What will he do here? Using his aerial tactics. Flying Bryant, what a counter! Countered into the head scissor. He is well schooled, very focused.
What a lovely spot here. Jam-packed, hottest ticket around anywhere.
The world is watching.
It certainly
Everyone
is.
Everyone is watching.
It follows him in.
And Martel didn't waste any time in taking advantage of the situation. Martel's relentless. Once he gets the upper hand, he stays right on your case and is now dishing out with some of the heavy artillery here.
So like him or dislike him, you gotta say that Rick Martel is one tremendous athlete.
Certainly a gut check time for the former Cincinnati Bengal.
Gorilla, when you look like the model, you gotta stand up there and let all the female fans get a look for us.
I guess. Oh, look at this!
One, two, and a half! Did he get it? Just a millimeter away! Would it be the situation? situation where maybe the first man to make a major mistake loses.
Backslide coming up. It could be all over. No.
That was almost what I would consider a major upset.
You can't beat Martel like that.
And now can Pillman capitalize?
Whoa. Nice clothesline. In for the ride. Back top and a beauty. And a model is in trouble. Little arrogance might help him here. Look out. Oh, Martel put his head down and paid the price.
Irish whips him across and follows him in. High risk offense off the top. Pillman cross body. That was 2 3/4.
Look at that small package.
He's got, no he doesn't. 2 1/2, I thought he had it. Very, very close. And again, getting no, another 2 1/2. They're putting their own bodies at risk as the moments tick by. That'll be all done. No, no it's not.
He's going for the loss of grab. He's got him turned over.
He's got it.
This kid from Cincinnati will not quit. Flying Ryan using his legs. He took a chance. He took a big chance through the air. What an aerial war. Both men obviously very groggy here. They're taking every chance they can. And the stakes are so high. And Pillman counter. Oh, what a move. And he got it.
Here's your winner.
Foundation paid close attention to those comments. And gentlemen, I must say you have been involved in some very controversial situations. This has got to top the list.
You say you're gonna rock the foundation. You say you're gonna move the foundation. You say you're gonna crack the foundation. Well, to crack the foundation, you've got to be right at the bottom. And that's exactly where you guys are, is right at the bottom. Tell them, man.
One of the mottos of the Hart Foundation is never say die. And the Hart Foundation, not like a lot of other tag teams, will never, ever fall by the wayside. Individually or tag team together, the Hart Foundation has the strength, we got the wisdom, and we've got tomorrow.
Let's go back out to the ring.
This is a tag team contest, scheduled for one fall.
About it. Here it comes. recent smash of Demolition, gentlemen, perhaps you heard some of the commentary from the Legion of Doom.
Animal Hawk, you stuck those ugly painted faces where they don't belong, and they're going to be a lot uglier by the time we get finished with them.
You imposters are going to regret the day you ever walked in the shadow of Demolition. And that shadow is going to get a lot darker, just like your futures. Dark, bleak, and hopeless.
And that simply means you're never going to forget the name Demolition, because we're going to totally demolish them. We're out to demolish and destroy.
Ha! Let's go back out to ringside.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Volkoff requests that you all rise and respect his singing of the Soviet National Anthem.
Just unreal six-man tag team action.
This is a straight grudge match right here. These two guys just do not like each other.
Backdrop, he ran right into it. No love lost here. Look out, clothesline city, he nailed him with it. Maybe we'll see that three-point stance here, Jess, very shortly. They are on fire. Oh, look at that nice hip toss there. They've got their work cut out for him, Jess.
Well, they definitely do, you know.
Oh, missed a knee in the corner. Oh, he stopped him dead in his tracks. We're not going to see too many flying head scissors, Jess, in this type matchup, but
you're going to see plenty of right hands from rugged Ronnie Garvin, though.
Scoop. Oh, beautiful slam. No, oh, up on top and over. There goes the champ, USA. And leading it, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Here it comes now.
He's setting up for it.
He's giving the signal for it. Dumped over the top, just stopped Duggan right in his tracks. Win if you can, lose if you must, but always cheat. Look out! Whoa! Look at that Nikolai. He doesn't have a clue how powerful he is. Oh, look at that. That'll get your attention.
Definitely will, definitely will.
Ram face first into the turnbuckle.
It's got to be the thick neck on it, because that would have knocked anybody else out. This guy don't know a hold from nothing. He's doing the wrong thing here, going after Hacksaw in the head.
Well, these kind of matchups just throw the rule book away and forget about it. Bear hug slapped on, and he could slap it out with the best of them. The entire world watching and still waiting in anticipation. Oh, look at this. Whoa. Right down into the canvas. Oh, look at this!
And he's got it in the middle of the ring, Gorilla. Too little, too late for Hacksaw Jim Duggan. He's out of it.
I don't think he's going to survive this. He's ripe for the pickets right now. Oh, there's some power. He got nailed and nailed good. Look out. Oh, reversal. Bottom by a clothesline. Duggan on the warpath. Duggan comes out the back door. He made the tag. A house of fire. Big touch. He nailed him with it. Starting to unload with a heavy artillery.
Oh, oh.
Fist shot right to the kisser. This one's getting out of hand, Jess.
Well, that's what generally can happen in a six-man tag match. You got only one referee and six guys in the ring.
Sunset Blade. Got him down. Look out. He got him. Some special pre-recorded interviews from Royal Rumble participants. Here they come.
hope you beer belly sharecroppers have a big box of tissues, because there's going to be a lot of wet eyes out there when you see your spineless cockroaches that you call your heroes go down in defeat against me, because it's every man for himself and I'm always a winner.
The time is at hand. The legacy, the destiny, it will be fulfilled today, because the mighty Hercules is ready to rumble, because I've got the strength and I've got the power and I'm ready for anything. Yeah.
It's the Royal Rumble, baby. And we already know our number, and it's right where we wanted to be, boys.
Nobody is safe from the earthquake. Everybody's going out. Everybody. Nobody is safe from me.
That's right, Jimmy. You're going to feel the earthquake. I guarantee it.
Get up off your feet. Put your hands together and do the bird with me. Oh, yeah. Because you see, in the World Wrestling Federation, brother, me and Frankie has been moving and grooving. And we're going to keep moving. Well, ain't nobody going to stop us. I don't care how big they are. I don't care how small they are. Nobody is going to stop Frankie and I. So get ready for the bird. Yeah.
WWF and WCW wrestling superstars battle to compete in the Royal Rumble to be the last man standing, including Raging Bull Manny Fernandez, The Rock Don Morocco, Dick Murdoch, Sam Houston, Dynamic Dude Shane Douglas, the mighty Hercules, Dick Slater, the Red Rooster, Freebird member Jimmy Garvin, adorable Adrian Adonis, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, Canadian Strongman Dino Bravo, Wahoo McDaniel, Birdman Coco Beware, Z-Man Tom Zink, Wild Bill Irwin, Bad News Brown, Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer, and the Earthquake. It's time to rumble! It's time for the Royal Rumble!
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the Royal Rumble! Allow me to explain the rules. In just a moment, numbers 1 and 2 will begin the event. And every 2 minutes thereafter, another wrestler will enter the ring according to the number he drew. To be eliminated, a wrestler must be thrown out of the ring, over the top rope, and onto the floor. The one wrestler remaining in the ring will be the winner. And now, let us all find out who drew number one to participate in the Royal Rumble.
The pile driver. They're on their way down.
possibly can will happen. Well, they're working as a team right now, Jess. He's got half of them out of there. Oh, look at that. There's no friends in this one. Look at the look on Bravo's face.
You can see all heads turn to see who number four is.
And doesn't look like he's in a big hurry to get there either.
Well, you know, not a good position.
Boy, got him out of trouble momentarily. Boy, they're doing a number on each other, too. Be interesting to see what the luck of the draw will be. I hope it's some help.
Sprinting down there to get in on this.
Who do you think he's going to side with, Jess? It's mayhem here!
You know, it's so exciting, Gorilla, because you have no idea who's coming next.
The clock is counting down. 5 seconds to one more participant. Who would it be? The action is hot and furious inside the ring. He's a fresh body in there, Jess. That makes a big difference. Every man for himself. It truly is that kind of an event. Counting down the seconds to another participant here.
This is an exciting match. Tremendously exciting because you just don't know who's coming down that runway next.
The action is so fast and furious in this Royal Rumble, it's literally impossible to describe it all to you. He's out of there! Look at her go to work. Every man for himself indeed in this spectacular Royal Rumble. A lot of guys just teetering on the brink here. Steps in. Oh, and he's back for the 360, and he's out of there. Get down there either. Some heavy duty action going on. What a dangerous match. All those arms and legs flying around in there. As this capacity crowd counts it down. Take a look at the charisma. Take a look at the power pack of The Rock. He's out of there. Some heavy duty action going on.
Whoa.
Oh, Rooster out of there. Off the top and gone. Look at this.
There's the countdown.
Who will it be?
Exactly what it says, Gorilla, a rumble.
It is
thousand feet.
Look at what an equal match off this is.
Talk about confrontations. You're looking at one. Oh, look at this. Is he happy with himself?
Certainly.
This youngster's on fire.
Ooh, who's coming now?
I don't know.
A good number because he's coming out awful late.
Gets rid of Coco.
Definitely eliminating some of the competition.
And he's out of there.
Man will be stepping into the ring with you tonight.
No, don't you say who it is, because I don't want him to know. I don't want anybody to know.
Wait a minute. This man has extraordinary physical capabilities.
Don't you say who it is. See, the honky-tonk man, the greatest intercontinental heavyweight champion of all time, can shake, rattle, and roll anybody the WWF throws at me.
All right, Jimmy Hart, and of course the Intercontinental Champion, the honky-tonk man, Jesse Gorilla. Let's get back to you.
I got long side burns in my hair, slick back. I'm coming to your town in my pink Cadillac. I'm just a honky tonk man.
Scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring, led by his manager, the mouth of the South, Colonel Jimmy Hart, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 247 pounds. Here is the intern.
WWE intent.
What a cheap shot. Wouldn't even let him get out of his Elvis suit.
Oh, look out. Get the Colonel out of there. Atomic drop coming up. Yes.
Oh, he's got him high, too.
Oh, he nailed him.
Oh, and does that hurt?
He caught him with an elbow.
Oh, man.
Look at this. Being rammed face first into that top turnbuckle. The honky-tonk, man. That adrenaline is flowing now.
This is horrible.
What a right hand by Koloff.
He's in dreamland almost.
Whoa.
Honky-tonk man really bent out of shape. Oh, here he goes.
Go.
Shake, rattle, and roll. Coming up.
If he hooks it, it's over. He got it.
Oh, he nailed him with it.
I think it's over if he wants it.
Oh, he's making a mistake here.
But Koloff, oh, what neck muscles. Koloff back on his feet.
When you nail somebody with your move, with your patented hold that puts the lights out that nobody gets up from, why not cover him?
But Koloff, when he has an opponent down, he is at his most dangerous best. Koloff, with that shoulder block, the intense competitor that we have grown to know.
Oh, look at that.
Look at
that. Give me a break. That's got to be a disqualification.
Oh, I can't believe this. Referee, get in there and stop this. The mouth is fighting for his life in there.
And there's Honky back to get him. Look at him.
Thumb in the eye. Stops the momentum here. Nice fireman's carry. Turns it into a sort of a half suplex, half slam. You know, with all that hip action he's got, the Honky Tonk Man still can wrestle, Grandma.
Oh, no questions about that. I never questioned his ability.
Honky on the second turnbuckle from the inside.
I don't think he wants a dance right now.
Well, he definitely doesn't.
Look at the champion pleading.
Can you blame him?
No.
He is a high impact, smack you right in the face kind of guy. And the Russian Nightmare has yet to let up. Tombstone Piledriver. Right there. A Tombstone Piledriver by the Russian Nightmare. Koloff got his arm caught for the Russian Sickle. That should be all.
Look at that. Referee trying to stop him, but to no avail. Scooped up. He nailed him again. That may be the end of the mouth of the shot. Oh, look at this. He's holding on the ropes.
Three, he got it. He got it. The Honky Tonk wins it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this bout, the Honky Tonk Man.
Did you mention something about a miscarriage, Jess?
I'll tell you what, this has got to go down as a major upset.
Major upset?
Major upset.
They stole it. They literally stole it. Running for his life, the Honky Tonk Man with a Pearl Harbor job.
Got away with it. I'll give you that. He got away with it. He got the win.
With me at this time, one of the most awesome tag teams ever assembled in history.
Can you feel it? Everybody out there right now, it's time for PS to do his stuff. It's time when the music gets grinding, you know, so PS got to be right on time. So this is the way it is. Ladies and gentlemen, it is showtime.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Introducing the first team from Bank Street, USA, in Atlanta, Georgia, the greatest rock and roll band of all time, the fabulous Reavers!
Piper, I can't believe a man can be quite so cocky, quite so arrogant.
Did you think I was gonna let you get away with that? Got a bit of a rep myself, you know. Got a little reputation that I gotta uphold. You think I ain't dealt with gorillas like you before? I can get a little rude myself there, young fella.
All right, only one of a kind.
I come here to fight. I don't know what you come here to do.
On that note, let's get back to ringside.
In the whole USA.
from Glasgow, Scotland, weighing 233 pounds, Rowdy Roddy Piper! From Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff!
Precision trained. Unbelievable coming to this moment.
Big scores to be settled here.
Look at the look on Piper's face. One of disdain and disgust.
Nose to nose in the center of the ring.
Oh, slap across the face. Oh, and a return slap. Piper now goes behind quickly, takes him down to the canvas.
The time for talking is over. The time for getting it on is right now.
It's the psych game right now. It's the psych-out game that's happening. Piper looks tremendous, and you can bet there's going to be plenty of damage done here. Piper's glaring out at the people.
Whoa!
Roddy didn't expect that. Look up. Oh, drops him like yesterday's newspaper. Jesse, it's just unreal what's going down.
And all four of them are going at it, and we're getting chaos 5 minutes into the match. Gino Monsoon, Ace is up there.
Can you believe this?
Unbelievable.
Anything and everything is going to happen. All three men outside now. Hot Rod Piper, Mr. Wonderful, and Ace Bob Orton.
Mr. Wonderful looks just unreal, Jesse.
He looks like a Greek god. Come on, referee, get him to open the hand. He's punching.
Last waist lock, go behind. Folded up like an accordion with that suplex. Gordy, what a move there. What a clothesline. Almost took his head off. Good drop toe by Bam Bam Gordy.
Take away all their pomp and circumstance, and they are very sound, fundamental wrestlers.
That is power! That is raw wrestling power!
Piper giving us a sign for timeout. They're headed for the dressing room, Jess.
I don't believe it.
No way.
Piper and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff are heading for a dressing room.
These gentlemen will have to return to the ring area. Mr. Wonderful now setting something up here. Look at this off the top turnbuckle.
This is tag team wrestling, Gino. Right now, I gotta say that Orndorff and Piper look the better precision team out there.
And Orndorff putting the boots to him.
I'll tell you, Paul Orndorff looks in the greatest condition I've ever seen him in, Gino.
Look out!
Unbelievable! The man is an athlete.
Orndorff up on the turnbuckle. What's he gonna come off with?
Oh, he got caught!
Wonderful, struggling to his feet. Can he make the tag?
There's the tag!
The tempo will quicken. And Michael Hayes with a nice move there. Wow, what impact. And we are here at ringside. DDT! Referee a little slow to get there for the count.
Look at that cheap shot by Hot Rod.
And there it is, the sweeper. He snapped it off. Right in the center of the ring. Oh, what a boot. That's Piper backwards over the top.
Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff with the cast.
Ace Orton delivering of the lookout. Piper with a chair. Pearl Harbor by Roddy Piper. What excitement and action.
What a matchup.
And as predicted and as expected, pandemonium breaking loose here. Holy mackerel. What action we've seen already.
Unbelievable, unbelievable.
The winner via disqualification.
Here we go. Let's go back and take a look at some of the events that led up to the end. He nailed him with it, knocked him right into the middle of next week.
Look at this. Wham! I mean, Jack Tunney should find and suspend this maniac.
Jake the Snake Roberts, the match is at hand.
You don't get it, do you? Because I'm going to tell you something. The reptile in a bag. You think for one moment that was what made Jake the Snake? No. The DDT is what made Jake the Snake. No doubt about it. I invented it. I perfected it. Nobody gets up now, do they? We all know that. Let me ask you this. You ever thought about the possibility, since there are no mats at ringside, if I DDT'd you on a concrete floor? You think about it. What would you look like? And remember this. A reptile in a bag is not what this snake's all about.
Longfellow couldn't have said it better.
Introducing first, hailing from the Double Cross Ranch in Canyon, Texas, weighing 241 pounds, Terry Funk.
up, and this is a physical situation. Bump's taking that table now around. Remember, it's no disqualification. Head first right across the table. How much punishment can one human being take? It shows you the uncanny resiliency of Terry Funk. He's going to go for it one more time.
Interesting tag team situation here. I've got to consider this one of the top contending tag teams in all of professional wrestling today. Apparently, you have irritated some folks in the World Wrestling Federation recently.
When you talk about Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard, you're talking about action personified. You're talking about the consummate tag team. And that's exactly what we are. It's called two men thinking singularly, working collectively towards the same goal. It's exactly what we do, and we do it better than anybody else.
Right now, let's go back to the arena.
And the total combined weight of 469 pounds, Davey Boy Smith, the Dynamite Kid, the British Bulldog!
And wrestling fans, their opponents, they're accompanied by the executive director of the Four Horsemen, James J. Dillon. They are the World Tag Team Champions, first from San Antonio, Texas, weighing 232 pounds, Tully Blanchard. And his tag team partner from the great state of Minnesota, weighing 270 pounds, Arn Anderson.
You're looking at two of the finest tag team combinations anywhere in the world today.
You're going to see some fine wrestling here.
Absolutely. Side headlock.
This is the guy I like in the team right here. Not only is he quick, but extremely powerful. You got two very powerful men in there right now.
Oh, beautiful maneuver.
It's busted loose early.
Well, the referee's going to have one heck of a time maintaining any kind of order in this one.
They know that ring generalship, Gorilla.
They certainly do. Two of the finest.
And that'll win you tag team matches. Whoa, look at that move.
Oh, beautiful. Wow. Counter for the hip lock.
I don't even know what you call that.
Pound for pound, just one of the most powerful guys that I know.
They've got to maintain their composure somewhat. We know that they're as physically intimidating as any two men that have ever stepped in a squared circle in the long, illustrious history of professional wrestling.
Oh, look at this. Oh, right out and over the top.
Well, both of these teams want the win so bad, they're not holding back on jumping into the ring.
Absolutely not. Look at this. Look. Wow. Hard to keep track of this one. The pace is so fast, Jess.
I'll tell you, Gorilla.
Boy, we're starting to get down to the nitty-gritty.
Hey, there's a tag made right there. Smart move.
Look out. Oh, nice clothesline. Suckered him right in.
thumbed him absolutely right in the eye.
Wow, he caught him.
He caught him in midair. Only the power.
And Blanchard's in big trouble right here.
Dropped like a bad habit.
From behind, he got clobbered.
Blanchard able to tag Arn Anderson into the ring.
They are experts at that.
The Horsemen created their own break. Blanchard was in deep trouble. James J. Dillon's interference has caused a major turning point in this tag team championship event.
You got to give the Horsemen credit, and James J. Dillon specifically, for the great positive attitude that the Horsemen possess. They have got a game plan. They feel like tonight they will indeed make wrestling history.
Oh, look at this! From the outside, Anderson plants one. Tully Blanchard can sense that they have the upper hand now.
Well, it's a gallant effort, but one against two, wow.
Oh, look at that move by Arn Anderson. Boy, once these guys get an upper hand, they're relentless.
But they've got a massive challenge because Anderson and Blanchard are as tough as they come. They do make a lot of tags, and they make the tags quite obviously when they are in control. But Anderson and Blanchard are now tagging in very precisely.
What a move by Arn Anderson right there. Beautiful.
Oh, waited too long right at the last split second. That'll buy him a little bit of time. He's crawling over there.
They're both hurting, though.
Maneuver by Dynamite.
This guy's just what his name says. He's a bundle of dynamite.
Snap suplex.
Wow.
Dynamite all the way up to the top box. It looks like Dynamite's back to 100%, Jess. Oh, look at this.
Beautiful press slam.
Power slam coming up.
Davey Boy Smith.
Oh, he got it. This one's getting out of hand, Jess. Referee having a heck of a time here. It's pandemonium. Hit him with everything to the kitchen sink.
Oh,
what a suplex. Oh, look at that. He might have knocked himself out. I don't think I've ever seen that. As the tag's made to Arn Anderson.
Wow. Oh, I love this. Now's when anything can happen.
Oh, look at this. Holy Moses.
Look at this.
Power is playing. And Arn goes for the ride. Look at this. What a shot. Here.
This could be disqualification, Gorilla.
My God, look at this!
Oh, the referee never saw that!
Wait a minute, what do we got going on now?
Oh, look at this!
Oh.
He might have knocked him out!
And Davey Boy's hurt bad.
I don't believe what I'm seeing here.
And he ain't moving.
The winners of the match! Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson!
Plenty of outside action going on in that one.
You know what? We got a lull here, Gorilla. I want to say hi to Terry, Tyrell, and Jade back in Minneapolis.
Oh, okay. This is going to be a beauty. Let's go to Hollywood.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the special submission match within the confines
Everybody's
of this 15-foot-high steel cage. The winner of this match will be that individual who makes his opponent submit or exit the cage through the door or over the top and on to the floor. Introducing the participants. Please.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, hailing from Virginia Beach, Virginia, weighing 242 pounds, Magnum T.A.
No love lost between these two, as is obvious.
And baby, they're getting it on, and they're getting on hard and fast in the early going.
Time out. There is no timeout in the world of professional wrestling.
Boy, these guys have no love lost. It's who can injure who in this situation. Referees are not even inside the cage.
Well, I've never seen the million-dollar man Ted DiBiase start this slowly before.
Oh, his face right here by us. My gosh. And in this time, he went right to the steel face first. Oh, he tastes the steel. His face went right into it. Badly lacerated here after his face ran into the steel. The cage is just like another weapon.
Got him exactly where he wants him right now.
Going for the quick win. Almost got him.
Oh! Whoa. Nice counter move by the Million Dollar Man, and no match is ever in the bag when you're in there with the Million Dollar Man.
Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man, is by far the more accomplished wrestler.
DiBiase sort of measured him now, Jess. Oh, and another shot right to the kisser. Oh! Leverage behind that move.
You know, mechanically, DiBiase thinks in that ring. He's a thinking wrestler.
But a ring in the face stopped that in a hurry. Backbreaker. Go for a suplex again. Oh, he nailed him with it that time. Well executed by DiBiase. He's just waiting here.
He's measuring him.
Remember, no disqualification. They're putting their bodies on the line. And you're seeing it at its most intense, violent best right here.
Why is he waiting?
He's wasted time here, valuable. And the seconds.
Took that cheap way out.
Cheap way out.
How can you not respect what you're seeing here? You gotta admire the intensity of these athletes. And it could be all here.
That could be the beginning of the end for the Million Dollar Man and his quest. Both men jockeying here. Oh, big roundhouse right.
Oh, what? Shot here. Look at this. Oh. Oh, my. And you can hear the smack of that.
Uh-oh, look out.
Ha-ha.
Unfair advantage here. You have somebody like Virgil outside the ring.
Well, I'm sure it was all checked out by the dictator, Jack Tunney.
I doubt that very much.
What a career-shortening match. Oh, what velocity.
He needs to worry about the Million Dollar Man.
From behind, he got clobbered. Well, that little move by Virgil certainly turned the tables here for the Million Dollar Man.
Oh, he's setting him up. He's going for the Million Dollar Dream, I think.
He's right in the right position. Oh, he's got that hand in there. He's got it. Yeah. Oh. Has he got the fingers locked? If he does, it's over.
Gorilla, this could be it.
And he is a battered mess. I've never seen that before. That's a capacity crowd. They're going to run by. Oh, yeah. It is deafening here.
Listen to this place, it's unbelievable!
Your winner, Magnum T.A.
Take on these two individuals who are known to use some very questionable tactics.
This is what you call a showcase event. This is in front of millions of viewers.
This is what makes you a competitive athlete tick. It is put up or shut up time. You said you could do it on your own. You haven't shown me that. That's not your track record. Well, this is your opportunity in front of millions of viewers to show everybody that you got what it takes. So bring on everything you got, because I got the adrenaline flowing, my blood pumping. I'm going to walk out of that ring as a U.S. heavyweight champion.
Let's go back to ringside.
Soon to be led towards the ring by his manager, Bobby of the Brain Heenan, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 250 pounds, Ravishing Rick Rude.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, funky-looking men to keep the noise down while I show the ladies what Simply Ravishing is all about. Hit the music.
From Chicago, Illinois, he weighs 275 pounds. He is the United States Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger!
This kid was recruited by every major college in the country coming out of high school. We know that he's a great power wrestler.
Gosh. Oh, what a chop.
Look at Luger. His pectoral development is second to none. We are talking intensity and emotion.
Look at this. Oh.
Can you imagine all the broken hearts that happened right there?
Luger's got him up. There's a power slam by Lex Luger.
Get a submission if it was anyone other than Ravishing Rick Rude. Oh, look at that move. Wow. Desperation. Whoa.
Kick off the top.
There it is, Gorilla. I thought he had him. I just can't believe it. You know, I picked this. This was my major upset pick, Gorilla.
Whoa. Look at that power. Rude in trouble again.
I've never seen Rude manhandled that way. Wow. And did you see Rude bounce 6 inches, 8 inches off that mat?
Serves him right.
Come on, Gorilla, quit playing such favorites out here. And I'll tell you what, Bobby the Brain better go to plan B. Heenan with a lot of concern as well. He should be right now.
Misses with a clothesline. Liver just manhandled.
Desperation move right there. Great presence of mind.
Pile driver.
All right. Oh, there goes Gorilla. I know Bobby prepared Rude. The hours and hours they spent together in the gym.
A little late with that cover.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, that wasn't the authority kickout that we saw earlier. Rude's getting closer, Gorilla. I can feel it.
Roll right to the back of the net. How are you going to hold a guy down with that kind of power?
Luger is just going now on guts.
And look at Rude. Where's the big muscles now, Gorilla?
Now's not the time to be doing that.
Oh,
perhaps
here we go.
A rude awakening. Coming up,
there it is.
Forget about it.
Upset.
Oh, wow.
he's going up again.
Ooh, Root's in trouble right now.
Oh, look at Luger. The adrenaline's going to be rushing through the body of the total package. He's got more than strength. I didn't know if he could do it. High impact moves. He is a power wrestler personified.
Oh, man. This could be it. There's got to be 1, 2, 3.
Oh, look at this.
And Bobby better watch out now because Rude's in trouble.
Oh, 360 by Rude. And Rude wants out of there. Rude's getting more than he bargained for.
Both of these guys are hurt, Gorilla.
It's Haku. Oh, Lord, and he nailed him.
He has been so close on so many occasions. Will this be the night that he...
Severe lacerations in the forehead of Lex Luger. Supervising Inspector Ray Iannucci have stopped the match. The winner,
Robinson Rick Rude.
Yeah! I told you they'd outsmart him, Gorilla.
Heenan, the brains behind the brawn here.
There you see how valuable Bobby Heenan is.
Referee did not see.
Oh!
And Heenan now caught inside the ring.
Look what's happening.
He deserves it, doesn't he? And look at Heenan. I love it.
Gentlemen, I've got to tell you, a lot of action out of that ring. I couldn't make heads or tails of half the things that were happening. Now, just exactly how does the Legion of Doom fit into the scheme of things?
Let me tell you something, Jim. Week after week after week, we've come out here and said, we want demolition. And you ignored us, demolition. Well, now, we hope you're mad. We hope you're good, man. Because demolition, we want you in the worst way. Tell them, Hawk.
You've been running roughshod over everybody. Well, if you look roughshod up in the dictionary, you'll see a picture of us. You're micro mini men in a big man's world, and we're the big men. Oh, what a rush!
Let's get back to ringside for more action.
Tag Team Champions, Jim Morrison.
face. Total determination. Total concentration. Oh, yeah! It's a fight! It's breaking out here! This should be most interesting.
What a matchup this is. I mean, this is power versus power.
Nice leapfrog. Look out. Look at the power. Stopped him dead in his tracks. Dropkick sent smash down. And now all four men in. Oh, dead into a clothesline.
The big blind shoulder block. And nails it. Brother, he nailed it. I'd be very surprised if this one goes past 10 minutes because the physical pound of that face. And Hawk comes in. Perhaps the more volatile of the Road Warriors. Boy, he's got, look at those definitions of his shoulders and arms.
These guys are awesome. Well, they're definitely big and strong. Gorilla. Big body slam.
He didn't just slam him. He tried to make him a permanent part of the ring.
And a double clothesline sends him to the canvas.
You talk about being able to hear the impact. It just doesn't get any more physical than this.
He's going for the pile driver. He's hit it.
He nailed it. Oh, look at this. What do I have to do to put this guy away?
Settled.
Got an arm ringer now, makes a quick tag.
Now, that's what they need to do. That's what the exactly Gorilla. They need to keep smashing their corner.
Big backdrop. That'll take some of the starch out of Demolition.
Gosh almighty, you could measure that one on the Richter scale.
He went in there at about 60 miles an hour.
And now Axe is just going to work. Like a machine. Like a jackhammer. I'd have to say Demolition the more polished at this point of the bout. Now if Demolition is smart, they'll do their roughhouse power stuff in the corner.
Well, they know how to cut the ring in half, Jess. No question about that.
Come on, you stinking pump!
Smash living up to his name. Smash it away and put the match back on the right track as far as Demolition is concerned.
Ooh, caught him with the elbow. They don't use a lot of classic wrestling moves, but they win.
That's really leveled him there.
Snapmare. Yeah, and again, Demolition dictating the matchup so far.
And Smash unloading now. Look out. Get, look at that. Oh, Smash has erupted here. I thought he was going to give a backdrop. He just took a step back and dumped him. Neckbreaker. Either one of these guys are right for the pickings right now. There's the tag. He is on fire. Lefts and rights in an Irish whipping. Oh, power slam and a beauty.
Could be it.
Could be all over.
Fatigue is going to be sitting into these big guys. Oh, yeah. Up top, high risk.
Oh, that's 300 pounds up in the air coming down. He ran into one by Smash. That'll give you a negative attitude forever. Oh, look at that shot by Smash.
Now there's a problem.
A big problem.
If he hits this, it's over.
To the earth, can get up or not get pinned after this one.
Yeah, the referee, if he wanted to, could see fit to disqualify somebody. Two and three quarters.
I've never seen the Road Warriors in this much jeopardy in their career.
Second turnbuckle on the inside once again.
There's more to this than meets the eye, I think.
Something stinks here. Look at Fuji. Oh, the referee never saw that.
Look at that. Cheap shot in my life, Matsu.
I loved it.
You loved it.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I may have your attention for just a moment, I would like to acknowledge the presence this afternoon of truly one of the greats, the one and only Jesse the Body.
Jesse the Body Ventura, maybe going to give us a couple of poses here. He certainly looks to be in great shape. Yeah, you're still in shape, Jess. You're here to chant, Jesse.
Approaching the ring area, weighing 257 pounds.
Ricky Steamboat, right now around the country, there's so much speculation about this match.
The day has finally come. The minutes, the seconds, we have reached our moment. As you and I climb into the ring, we clash like two titans. But there will only be one winner.
Let's get back to ringside.
Weasel has just snuck into the broadcast booth.
How am I doing, Monsoon, huh? I am on a roll. Talk about my career, what I'm doing. I am making history here. I got two wins, and I'm going to have three wins today.
Go behind by Mr. Perfect, and these two men are so technically sound, it's amazing.
Boy, those moves are crisp, they're sharp, they're fast. This is wrestling.
Oh, what an offensive exchange. Then Perfect counters by kicking away.
Let me tell you, I know Perfect. Perfect will take a win any way he can get it.
All right in the face there that time.
I was going to mention how aggressive they are. They're not laying back.
Two phenomenal athletes, and they're giving all they got right here.
Boy, are they reaching down to get what they have to.
Right by the hair. And it is getting down and dirty here. Ooh, what a chop.
Sends him over the top rope and down to the concrete. Both guys taking a lot of liberties here in this one. They know how much is at stake.
It is very obvious what the focus of this match will be. As far as Steamboat is concerned offensively, man, these guys are extending themselves to phenomenal bounds here. Tremendous conditioning, these two, putting their bodies on the line. Steamboat going for the submission. That's a submission move. He's got him there. happy that you're with us.
Take a look, jam-packed, 20,000 plus ahead, and who knows how many millions around the world.
Look at this. No one's going out for popcorn. No one's getting autographs.
A shot right over the head of the referee, right in a kisser. Look out. Dropkick of the beauty.
Perfect. You can't let him get his wing. You can't let him walk. There you go. Go after him. This is the beginning of the end. Perfect's in command. I know that look. I know the way he operates.
Sleeper hold. Sleeper hold on Mr. Perfect.
Cinch up. Cinch up. Will you stop? I'm not going to tell you again. You'll be out of here.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
The drama keeps building and building.
Two. And an air fall by Mr. Perfect. They've got to be careful.
In 10 minutes.
No, he got
it out. Nobody's ever kicked out of that. Maybe some of the worst officiating I've ever seen. Kicking out of the Perfect Punch. That might have demoralized Mr. Perfect.
That shows you how he is geared for this match.
And look at this. It's retaliation time. Already too much has been taken out of Mr. Perfect.
No.
Oh, was that close.
Steamboat. Inside cradle. 1-2 and a half.
The count. He's trying everything.
Irish maneuver coming up. The altitude is high. Oh, that come down. What impact. He's taking a chance here.
That could be the climax blow right there.
No.
My God, I thought he had him.
Both men groggy and rightfully so.
I can't believe it. I don't see how they can go much longer at this pace. What a classic confrontation between these two superstars.
The pain. Excruciating for Mr. Perfect.
Almost got him.
Well, this match is taking a lot out of both of them.
This could be all. Will this be all? No, it will not.
I have never seen a match go one way, then the other, back and forth so many times.
Tombstone pile driver, Steamboat. Walking back over. Only time in a tombstone. If he hits it, it could be over.
Oh, look at this.
Mr. Perfect trying to go for his favorite maneuver. The Perfect Punch. Oh, it's countered. It's countered.
Here's your winner, Ricky the Dragon
about determination, talk about guts. It is a happening. History has been made in a number of ways. Let's keep the action going. Let's go back down to ringside.
Steiner, Bro Steiner Brothers!
elbow tie-up, and we are ready to go. Side headlock applied. We all wondered how they would approach this match mentally.
You know, I've heard a long time about the Steiners, how big they are, how tough they are, how bad they are. Oh! Well, I want to just see for myself. Well, shut your mouth and watch it.
You shut up.
They are competitive. The adrenaline is flowing, though the amateur style out the window.
Top. Oh, look at that.
In the meantime, Steiner Brothers climbing up to the top here. The Steiners on top. A couple of big time Steiner lines from up top. And the Steiner Brothers are walking tall here right now at this point in time.
You know what I've noticed about the Steiners? They never keep a hold on you too long. They love to pick you up and just heave you in the air and throw you down as hard as they can.
Steiner Brothers, what awesome team, no doubt about it. Got him feeling his belly up and over. Tremendous conditioning and desire and strength. Oh, he got hit. He got hammered. What a power move there. He may have suffered his shoulder right there. Bret the Hitman Hart is in deep, deep trouble here. Well, a victory.
Tremendous athletes. Great tag team partners. That's what makes them great.
But you can't hurt them. You hit them in the head all day.
Oh, did you see that, Bray? Did you see that?
Oh, reversal now. Wow.
Oh.
He got hammered. With a tremendous clothesline. Will this be all? No, it
no!
No, it will not.
Well, they have really taken it to the Steiners.
Scott Steiner being really tested here.
And they're keeping Scott Steiner on their side of the ring. Suplex coming up. Now seeing the continuity of the Hart Foundation.
Oh, headbutt.
Look at the excellence of execution there.
Buries that shoulder deeper to the midsection.
What a smart team. What a great move. And they've cut the ring in half. They've kept Steiner in their corner. It's that instinct, Ross. You wouldn't know that. You're from Oklahoma. Your biggest deal is milking a pig.
Listen to this chant here by this capacity crowd.
Man, these guys are, they are hammering each other.
Boy, they want it bad, don't they? They're fighting for everything.
Hold up right there. Well, this gives Scotty the opportunity to make the tag to Rick. And Scott Steiner tags in Big Brother. Steiner line.
Oh, look at that. Well executed.
He, oh,
look at that.
He caught him in air with a slam. There is nothing in the world like WCW.
What great moves.
Is a physical matchup. Curious position here. Running power slam. And another near fall. His head cracked right against the post. Uh-oh.
Oh, beautiful.
Inverted atomic drop. A side wrestle leg sweep. Elbow. Lateral press.
No. He don't have him. He don't have him. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And boy, you better take advantage of it.
Caught him in mid-air for that power slam.
That impressed me.
A scintillating move. Oh, impact. Oh, impact. Turned him inside out. Scott Steiner belly to belly. 2.5.
Bye-bye, Hitman.
Oh, it's got him. He can't let this happen. He's got him up on his shoulder. This will be all. You got to think for the Hitman. Oh, my gosh. He was taken from the middle ring all the way outside.
He went up from this.
Oh, counter. He countered just barely. Got a shoulder up.
Irish
with far side. And Scotty, there's a Frankensteiner! There is a Frankensteiner! And it's brought him out of their seats! This is amazing!
He's still got fight left in him. The Hitman is on. Look at this move!
He's got the clean hook!
Jesse, this has been the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time, and there's still a whole lot more to come. So let's go right now to our interview center with Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, my guests at this time are going to be facing in a three-on-three encounter as it comes down to it now. Your last-minute thoughts.
Ooh, and let me tell you about my thoughts tonight. Excitement galore tonight. Just a few moments, you get your opportunity to show the public that Dusty Rhodes can wrestle. And brother, we know I can dance circles around you. And now you say prove to me in public, if you will, you can mark this one down tonight. I'm gonna kick your booty. Ha!
You know what you're up against. Size this one up. You know what the stakes are.
Pride is what is up for grabs. All I gotta say is, you say you gotta do what you gotta do. Well, guess what? The Stinger's gotta do what he's gotta do. Also, much. I want you so bad I can taste you.
All right.
Over the Stinger's dead body, my friend.
All right, I thank you very, very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
What did you think? What's gonna happen? When I arrived here, I told Hogan face to face, he was short-lived. And by God, he is. Little babies out there now, tears in their eyes. Mothers looking at their fathers, wondering what's next. Well, I'll tell you, all these years, you believed in Hogan. You may have said your prayers. You may have taken their vitamins. You may have gone to the end of the earth with him. But now it's all over. There's one, just one world's heavyweight champion. And you got to know it's me. Woo!
Standing by in another part of the building with the opposing view, let's go to our broadcast colleague, Sean Mooney. Sean?
These are the Hulkamaniacs, and set to lead them into battle is Hulk Hogan.
Well, you know something, little dude. We're not too worried about the odds being stacked against us, you know. This is what it's all about, brother. I've been around the WWF for quite some time now, and the Hulkster has always ruled. But never before have I seen such intensity in a man like the Ultimate Warrior, brother, to rise to the top so fast, to take it all away. And as far as I'm concerned, we're going to survive this thing, brother.
I must do what our forefathers have always done. Never afraid to face an adversary. Always willing to step into a new frontier. Always willing to make a sacrifice. It is these things that are the lifeblood of the Ultimate Nation. And it is these things that are the lifeblood of the Ultimate Warrior.
What it is what it is. Yes, I have bent the rules a time or two, and I reserve the right to do it in the future, yeah. And I don't apologize for that at all. Macho Man Randy Savage is bad to the bone, yeah. And I got a heart made of stone right now, and I'm living on the edge of a lightning bolt, and I do not apologize for that. No, I don't. I will rock you, Ric Flair, and there's nothing that you can do about it. No, I'm going to bring you all the way down if you come after the madness, because I'm the type of person not to forget anything in this world. And that is the bottom line. Oh, yeah!
This is our chance to prove that the four demands of the training, the prayers, the vitamins, and believing in yourself will make you a survivor in any situation, man. What you gonna do when my team of survivors runs wild on you?
All right, back to you, Gorilla.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the main event of the evening.
Wrestling fans, at this time, it gives me a great deal of pleasure to introduce what you have been waiting for.
Introducing from Allen, Texas, weighing 289 pounds, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes!
Yeah.
five-time World Heavyweight Champion, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair!
We can say right now.
Vince is trying to reach down. He's trying to block out any pain.
Big time offense by Sting. Oh, my God, what an offensive move.
Did you see the smart move by Macho? Gets it back to his advantage. That's skill wrestling, Gorilla.
Beautiful clothesline.
Quick move by the Macho. Listen to the pukesters.
The Hulkster drops
second elbow. I'll tell you what. I don't understand how the pukesters can cheer for this guy. He's as dirty as they get, Gorilla.
Oh.
Sharpest team. He is a fighter. And a big desk is rocking to him. Rhodes is setting for it.
Oh, he moved out of the way. Look out, the big splash. 1, 2. Yes! Warrior refusing to go down, Jesse. The man is extremely powerful. And look at the energy. Still possessed by the Ultimate Warrior.
If he hits this gorilla, it's over.
This suplex. How much power? One man's going to take as the champion is starting to unload with that heavy artillery.
Woo! Quinn is not a quitter, and he's too good to be pinned.
Oh, look at this now. Oh, Ben pulling out all the stops here. So much at stake. Whoa. What did I run into?
He's saying, show me what you got.
Look at this. Distraction. Oh, I think the Warrior is missing the boat here, Brain. Oh, come on. Give me a break. Oh,
no. Give me one.
What?
Woo!
Come on. Spit that banana out and do it.
Give me a break.
Look at the intensity. Look at Sam. Look at whoa.
Come on, Rep. Do your job. Oh, look at this. Come on, Rep.
Yeah. It's only time now. It's only time.
Take him out now, player. Don't play around him anymore. Take him out. We're going to break that head. He's going to slap that figure forward. Snap, crackle, and pop. Dantum. Dantum. There comes the figure four. He's got it. He's got it. It's over. Piece of cake. Nothing to worry about. Flair's playing with him like a child with silly putty or a slinky spring. Never have I seen the Hulkster in trouble like he is right now. No, no, no. The Hulkster's out of there.
Come on, Rick. Come on, champ. Take it to him. Stop it. Cut him off. Oh,
the pendulum has swung. In this one, the tide is indeed turned. Yes.
Sir, I've never seen this man so intense. I followed his career. I know everything about this man. He's lost it back. Everything is on the line. Maybe the humanoids don't understand it. Everything is on the line.
Perhaps we'll see that patented elbow. Yes.
That is it. What, he's going to get it.
This place is going crazy.
Kiss of death. Take it while you got it.
Hey, again.
Take him. Take it. No.
Seven. We're seeing history made here. That's four. And he's still going. He's not moving. No one's going to be able to get up from this kind of punishment. What a display here.
Take him on, son. He's on his feet after five. Elbows up the top rope.
No,
no, no, no. 1, 2. No, he didn't get up.
I can't even talk anymore.
He's done. Inside cradle. The DPO. Yes.
This crowd here is electrified. He needs to go.
It's for you, baby.
She winked at him.
She did not.
She did too. It's Bedlam Mayhem here.
For being with us at this happening, this wrestling event of all time, Gorilla Monsoon, along with my colleague, Jesse the Body Ventura, saying so long from ringside.
Unbelievable, Gorilla.